Hi guys and welcome to Crazy Burger. So in this video I'm going to be starting a new series looking at every Evercade cartridge and making sure it's compatible with the Super Pocket. So this video is really intended for new Evercade users and new users of the Super Pocket. And obviously a lot of you guys won't know what cartridges are available, what games are available, what they like, are they compatible with the Super Pocket. So I'm going to start from the beginning, going through all the collections. In this video I'm just looking at collections 1 to 5, checking out some of the games, making sure they're compatible and give you my overall thoughts on their compatibility with the Super Pocket. So let's get started. Okay guys, so the first collection we're going to look at is Atari Collection 1. Now this goes way back to the original Evercade. I think it came packaged with the original Evercade. This is cartridge number 1. Has 20 games. They're all Atari 2600 and 7800 games. Some really good stuff here. Obviously if you loved Atari, you'll love this kind of thing. If you don't really like that or don't have any nostalgia for it at all, you may want to give this one a miss. But there are some really good games here. There's the original Adventure, Centipede, Alien Brigade, Asteroids, Crystal Castles, The Awesome Food Fight, The Weird as Heck, Ninja Golf, and a lot more besides. Some really good stuff, 20 games. So let's have a look at a few of them now. Also, a quick note here, guys. A few of these carts are going to be tagged as legacy carts, and that means that they are no longer being manufactured by Blaze. Now this one particular, Atari Collection 1, will be out of production at the end of 2023, but you should still be able to pick this up from many stockists, and if you get stuck you might even find it on eBay or somewhere else. But hopefully if you pick up now you'll still be able to play, sort of pay the $17.99 price or whatever you're paying this from. Okay, so here are some of the games. I'm not going to play through all of them. I've had a quick check through some of them and most of them play absolutely fine on this device. It really is up to you whether you want to play these type of games on this device. But this one's pretty decent. This is Alien Brigade. It is obviously a little bit like Operation Wolf, which you'll already have, and it's probably arguably not as good as that. But it's okay. It's certainly a playable, fun game to get stuck into. Very much the same, a crosshair shooter. It plays nice enough. I certainly think that this screen is perfect for this type of game. Well, let's have a look at some other games. Okay, there's many, many games here. Obviously, we'll have a quick look at this, the classic Asteroids as well. And this is actually pretty decent. On the other collection, there is the 7800 version, which probably would be a little bit better. But yeah, it's nice and colourful and it looks really nice on this screen. Certainly seems a really nice fit. I think the colours actually pop quite nice on this little screen. Not really my favourite type of game, but if you like this type of thing, then this is pretty good fun for your Super Pocket. Okay, there's tons and tons of stuff there. I'm certainly a big fan of Centipede. That is good fun. Let's have a look at that. Obviously it utilises the full screen, unlike the arcade version, which is kind of a... obviously in the vertical aspect ratio, which isn't really ideal at all for this type of screen. But this version is fantastic, and arguably I think this is the better version. Obviously there's tons, Crystal Castles, Desert Falcon, some really good stuff here. Food Fight is fantastic as well. And it does seem to me that these games play fantastically well on this device, and some really good classic stuff. But again, these games won't be for everyone. If you don't have nostalgia for them, then I don't really think you'll like it much. However, there's some really good games here. Okay, moving on to Namco Museum Collection 1. This is collection number 2. And it has 11 games. Now sadly this is also a legacy collection, meaning it's no longer made by Blaze, but you might be able to pick it up from somewhere such as eBay, or maybe even CEX stores in the UK or something like that. You might find one somewhere. But yeah, bear in mind there are a few collections like that on Evercade now, and I will highlight that through the videos that I make for the Evercade cartridges. But let's have a look at some of the games. On Namco Museum 1 was Galaxian, Pac-Man, some really classic stuff, Dig Dug, Mappy, and a few others here that you might recognise. A lot of these are either NES sort of versions, or I think the Quad Challenge might be a Mega Drive game. Can't really remember, but we'll find out once we get started. I think the majority are NES conversions, but that's not a bad thing. Some of these NES conversions, like Mappy, I actually think is better than the arcade original. Let's have a look at a few of the games. Okay, so let's have a look at the Namco Collection 1. Battle Cars, Dig Dug, Galaxian, Level Rabble, Mappy. Some real good stuff in here. Okay, let's have a look at the classic Pac-Man. This is obviously the NES version, but it's still really decent. And as you can see, it works perfectly for this little screen. Try to keep the sound down low so you can hear me, because the sound certainly does pop on this little device. But for me, this is the type of game you probably want to play on your Super Pockets. Certainly for those sort of 5 minute quick fix games, I think this is absolutely fantastic. Okay, there's a few other games here. Look, Quad Challenge is a kind of a driving game, Starluster, a spacey game. Xevious is a shooter, Battle Cars, Dig Dug's a classic. Let's have a look at Galaxian, an all-time favourite for me. I'm not really a big shooter fan, but I definitely like Galaxian, especially on the Atari 2600. But this is the NES version again, and it's really good fun. And as I said, I think this is probably better than the arcade version for me. I think this is terrific. This is obviously a NES conversion, but I think it's absolutely brilliant. So definitely a really fun game to play. Thoroughly enjoy it. And this cart is a pretty decent one as well. Hopefully you can pick it up pretty cheap if you are interested. Okay, moving on to Data East, or Data East Collection 1. This game, this cart came with 10 games. This is cart number 3, and this was certainly one of my early favourite collections. And it's still an excellent sort of cart, coming with a lot of really good games. It's a mixture of NES, SNES, and Mega Drive titles. Bad Dudes is NES, yeah, Midnight Resistance is Mega Drive. That type of thing. There's some really, really good games here. Fighter's History is fantastic. Get Magical Drop, which is a kind of a Bust a Move style game. Two Crude Dudes, Burning Rubber, Side Pocket. Some really good games here, a really good variety cart. This is certainly one of those ones I would highly recommend to any collector on Evercade. But let's have a look at a few of the games now. Okay, Data East Collection 1. Some really cool games here. This is definitely one of my early favourite collections. I wouldn't really recommend Burger Time unless you're a big fan. I felt the controls are a bit sticky. So if you do get it, don't blame the D-pad. The game is just like that. Burn Rubber is great fun. Fighter's History. Let's have a look. Absolutely love this game. Arguably, I prefer it to Street Fighter. I don't know why. I found it a lot easier to get stuck into. Maybe it's just me, I found Street Fighter sometimes can be a little bit too tough to play. With this one I felt, I don't know, it's very much similar, but I prefer this one. Easier to pick up, not as frustrating. Okay, let's have a look at some of the other games on here. Joe & Mac is a really cool sort of platformer style game. Magical Drop is pretty much like Bust a Move. Midnight Resistance, let's have a bash at that, really cool. Now, I don't really see any massive issues with these games on this collection, and most of them should be absolutely fine. I don't think we'll have any massive issues till we get to some of the later collections, to be honest, but it's worth having a check anyway. You might not be all too aware of what games are on here. This is a great game, and for the Super Pocket, it looks fantastic. Colours are popping, controls are fantastic, really easy. I think, though, I'm not really keen on the button layout for this, but obviously there's no way of changing the button layout on this device, so you kind of just have to make do with what it is. I'd rather the A button was the jump, to be honest, rather than the B button, but you know, it is what it is. Okay, so this is Side Pocket. It's kind of a pool game, and it's pretty good. I just kind of think maybe the table looks a little bit small on this screen. But I think it's just about playable. But you can see here the balls on the table are a little bit small maybe. But overall I think it's playable. There isn't actually that many pool games on Evercade. I think we have Arcade Pool on Team 17 collection, and then there's this one as well. Okay, last game we're going to look at is Two Crude Dudes, which is an excellent Mega Drive fighter. Obviously it's a conversion of the arcade game. Now a lot of these games are two-player games, two-player compatible, but yeah, you can't play them two-player on the Super Pocket, sadly. Maybe one day we will, but this one is perfect for this device. The graphics are absolutely popping, really colourful, and obviously the graphics are pretty large, or the sprites are pretty large, so it's perfectly fitted for this device. Okay, moving on to Interplay Collection 1. This comes complete with 6 games, and this was collection number 4. And this one probably wasn't massively popular at the time, but it does contain one of the iconic games of its time, Earthworm Jim, which was a decent enough game, pretty hard, but it's certainly iconic. It's one of those games I certainly owned on the original Mega Drive. Has Clay Fighter as well, which has a lot of fans, Battle Chess, Boogerman, Incantation and Titan. Probably not the best cart, I would say, and I don't really see many people saying this is one of their better collections or favourite collections on Evercade, but let's have a look at some of the games now. Okay guys, let's have a look at Interplay Collection 1. Yeah, we'll jump straight into Battle Chess, just to sort of make it clear that this game is pretty awful. It's probably the only chess game we have on Evercade. It looks fine on this little screen, but it's a bit of a painful, slow, laborious game to play, given the fact that these sort of characters move in real time. It's like, oh, so boring. You can actually turn that off, and I'd probably, if you do pick this game up, I would turn it off and play it as a normal chess game rather than watching the characters move, because it is pretty boring as heck to play through. But it actually looks absolutely fine on this little screen. Okay, there's a few other games. We've got Boogerman, which is a kind of a weird platformer. We'll get Clay Fighter, Earthworm Jim, Incantation and Titan. Titan is a kind of a puzzle game. Let's have a quick look at that. It does have jerky scrolling, so that's not really a Super Pocket issue. This is more like just how the game was. Okay, so this is Titan. You're basically trying to guide this metal ball with the square to take away all the other blocks on the screen. Yeah, and the scrolling is very, very jerky, and even though this game is actually initially quite fun, that jerky scrolling gets a little bit irritating in the later levels, and it kind of is pretty off-putting to play. And on this little screen it's probably even worse. It's definitely not ideal at all. I mean, there is fun to be had. If it only didn't have that jerky scrolling, I think this would be good fun. But that jerky stuff is just completely off-putting. So let's have a look at some of the better games on the collection. Obviously there's the iconic Earthworm Jim, which I'm pretty sure most people have heard of at some point. It was on pretty much every format you can think of. Was it a great game? It was certainly an interesting game, great animation, lots of funny stuff going on. But it was a pretty hard challenge, that's for sure. Very colourful graphics, look absolutely fantastic on this little handheld. Yeah. Again, I feel the button mapping is never great on these games. I would probably change them about. But yeah, that's not an option on the Super Pocket. So you really have to make use with whatever the button mapping is on every game. I kind of feel that the jump should be A again rather than the Y button. But yeah, it seems to be pretty decent. It looks fantastic. It certainly pops on this little device. Okay, we'll probably have a look at Clay Fighter as well. That's a kind of a one-on-one beat-em-up, which isn't a favourite of mine, but I know there are a lot of fans out there for this game. See, it looks absolutely fine on this little device. Sometimes you think some games just wouldn't work, but this one certainly does work. It's just I don't really enjoy it. I feel it's far too hard, frustrating, lack of moves kind of thing. Great graphics though, it looks fantastic, but never enjoyed it. But yeah, I'm pretty sure there's plenty out there that do. Just not me. Okay, final collection for this video is Atari Collection number 2. Now, it is a bit similar to the first collection. It has 20 games. They're all kind of a mixture of 2600 and 7800 games. This is cart number 5. And yeah, just like the first collection, this is a legacy cart. It will be out of production at the end of 2023. Meaning, if you want this, you probably want to try and get it as soon as possible before the prices start to skyrocket. But yeah, there's a good selection of games here. You've got the classic Yars Revenge, Solaris, the 7800 versions of Centipede and Asteroids, Desert Falcon and a few others. There's some really, really good games here. However, if you don't have any nostalgia for this type of stuff, then you might want to give it a miss. But it certainly holds up well on the Super Pocket. So let's have a look at a few of the games now. Okay, we're on to Atari Collection 2. 20 games to look at. There are tons here. Got Asteroids again, the 7800 version, Basketball 7800. So some basic Atari 2600 games, 7800 version of Centipede. Now I reckon out of the two Atari collections, I really would probably choose this one over the other one. There's a lot of repetitive games as well. We've got the 7800 version of Desert Falcon, which is miles better than the 2600 version. Haunted House, Human Cannibal, which is actually pretty funny. Millipede, Planet Smashers, pretty decent. Radar Lock, Real Sports Tennis, Solaris, Sprintmaster. Street Racer, Submarine Commander, Wizard. Oh, and Yars Revenge. Yeah, let's have a bash at Yars Revenge. I don't really see any massive issues with any of these games on this device. I've played most of them and they're absolutely fine to play. I loved this one back in the day. Great game, absolutely loved it. Okay, we'll also look at another favourite of mine. We'll have a quick look at Solaris. But I don't really see any massive issue with these games. I think they'll all be absolutely fine. Again, just like the first collection, it will not be for everyone. This looks absolutely fantastic on this little device. This game was an absolute classic, really loved it. And for an Atari 2600 game, it certainly had a lot of depth, which probably isn't the same with every game that you'll pick up on the 2600. So there's also a basketball game, basketball, which is kind of cool. I've actually got a few basketball games on the Evercade, which is kind of amusing. Not sure any of them are that great, but anyway, here we have it. I'd ideally would love NBA Jam, that's the one to have. But this is alright, it plays fine, looks absolutely fine, this device. Colours are popping as usual. Okay guys, that's our look at the first 5 collections on Evercade on the Super Pocket. And I think there's some really good collections, maybe worth picking up. So in the next video, we'll also look at collections number 6 to 10. Look out for that. Thanks very much for watching. Bye for now.